My dear friends, this video I'm going to start with one thank you. Just with these two words, thank you. 3 days ago, I managed to monetize this channel. And this is all because of you and thanks to you. And I'm grateful to you from the bottom of my heart. Hvala vam. Thank you. Danke schön. Obrigado. Gracias. Arigato. Xie xie. And in all other languages I didn't mention. Спасибо! In this video I'm going to be talking about the K and KE-Jetronic again. Because I have a feeling that you didn't quite understand the way KE and K-Jetronic function. So I had to make this video. Well, you see, for K and KE-Jetronic, it is the most important thing that we have a constant pressure that must stay within its nominal values. And the second thing is that this pressure must be held steady, firmly. It mustn't fall. For example, it's not like the newer models. KE-Jetronic has to maintain this pressure steady. Only 0.1 bar is tolerance. Just 0.1 bar. That's all the tolerance you can get. Because look, now, this, you know what this is. This is the fuel pump. This generates the pressure. And this thing, this maintains that pressure. This thing maintains the working pressure if you want to have a good operating engine. So we conclude that these two components are the key components for the K and KE-Jetronic. The fuel pressure regulator has to maintain the pressure. It has a spring inside and the membrane, the diaphragm. And as it gets ruptured, then the gasoline flows out of here. And then you have a loss of the pressure. And your car loses pressure and it dies something. When you press the accelerator, it goes something like it won't accelerate as it should. And then you cannot have a good accelerating engine. One more thing. This thing, as I said, it's the fuel pressure regulator. And this little guy, this is the fuel accumulator. Well, my feeling is that you don't make a difference between the fuel accumulator and the fuel pressure regulator. Now, this UFO guy, I call it UFO. This thing has the task to harmonize the vibration coming from the fuel pump. It rests down there. You have the pump, the fuel filter, and then the fuel accumulator. As the engine is warm and off, this thing maintains the constant pressure. It also has a spring and a diaphragm. And then it maintains the constant pressure within its nominal values. So when you then later start your car, then you can start it easier, because you know that a cold start and a warm start are two different things concerning the K and KE-Jetronic. So this guy, this is the one, the culprit, that when you have a warm start issues. And you know that video, I can post it here, where I show you how to test this fuel accumulator. And if that test fails, then you will have to do it other way. And the other way is... me and my fuel distributor. Would you believe it? Now, the thing you're going to do, you're going to take your pressure gauge, and then, let me show you, you're going to hook up your pressure gauge at the fuel distributor, and then you're going to start the car. Why would you do that? First thing you want to do, that's because of this guy, because of this little thing. You'll start it, and then you're going to press the accelerator lever. And if the pressure falls, then you have a bad fuel pressure regulator. And then you will get that bad accelerating. Not like this. And afterwards, you're going to stall the engine in order to test this little guy. And how do you do that? Well, you simply stall the engine, and then you wait. For how long? For half an hour. And within this half an hour, the pressure this guy has to maintain must stay within 3 bar, and it mustn't fall. Let me repeat that. As you stall the engine, the pressure must remain 3 bar within half an hour.
What did you say?
It mustn't drop under 3 bar. If it does, well, you have a bad fuel accumulator. If the pressure drops as you press the accelerator, then you have a bad submarine. I hope you liked my video. If you did, then happy Mercedesing. Bye.